We're going to go through now something we call in the P2 world quadruped limb extensions. You guys call them bird dogs, and bird dogs is a wonderful way to get core stability. This one goes off the rails big time. So we're going to start off real slow. I'm going to give you a bunch of pieces to put together and just monitor your own body when you're doing this. It's a lot more involved than you might think. On all fours, please. Hands underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. Hip distance apart. She'll find her spinal curves, so her neck will go into a little bit of an arch and her low back will be in a bit of an arch. Let's move your hips back a little bit, there we go, and we got a nice square underneath the body there. Okay, those of you who have been on the journey with us here, you know we need to stabilize. We're calling it securing the perimeter now before she lifts any limbs. So she'll do a light pull up of her belly button, remember 3 points on the dress shirt, one right at the bottom of the rib cage, one at your belly button, and one by your pubic bone. So exaggerate it, Alva. If you really pull that up, her whole back will start to flex and come up because she's pulling so hard. It's half of that, just enough to stabilize. She'll put her tight wetsuit on, so there's a zipper from the back, and as we start to pull the zipper up, it corsets in and contracts her transversus abdominis muscle. She'll pull her egg up into her pelvis, the imaginary egg or the elevator for the pelvic floor, all stable. With that, she'll inhale and exhale and straighten your left leg straight back behind you. She's going to use her glute, she's going to use her core, and pull your toes back towards your face. Lift your leg a bit higher. So Alva's done this a lot. Look at this. She's got a perfectly level back here. The block is level. Lots of you will be off to your side. You want to try to keep that in position. If you can hold all of this in place, take your right arm out in front of you. Your palm will face inward, and she'll lengthen out. Imagine there's a block. Look what happens as she pushes her foot into the block. The leg raises. Hold that, honey. Don't let it down. Good. And hold that position. So a little bit shaky, but not so wobbly. If it's too wobbly, don't pick your hand up. Okay, slowly, she'll put her hand down. She'll put her knee down. She'll take a rest for a moment, and then we'll do the other side. We'll add to it each time. So this time, she'll take her left knee a little closer to the center of the mat. Pull your belly up. Zip into your wetsuit. Pull up the egg. Hold stability. Inhale. Exhale, take the right leg out. Push it into an imaginary block. If you're real wobbly here, turn yourself and push your foot to the wall. That will help to stabilize. Take your left arm out in front. And hold that position. So if I take my hand to her body and start pushing her around, she's not wobbling all over the place. She's got a good stability. Take your left hand back down. Take your right leg back down. And switch back to the other side. So she'll take the right knee to the center of the mat, inhale, exhale, left leg out, all those pieces held, right arm comes up. If this feels like you're stable enough, rock forward a little bit and it will destabilize. And if it's still okay, start to shake an arm and a leg and that will really tax the system. Bring it back to its neutral. Gracefully, the arm goes down, the leg goes down. She would repeat it on the other side.